Alright guys, so before designing a column, make sure you are familiar with these 8 points for column design. Point number 1, which is about longitudinal bar percentage. So according to ACI, percentage of longitudinal steel bar must not be less than 1% nor more than 8% of the total gross cross-sectional area of the column. So the minimum limit of the longitudinal, or you can say the main bar, that's just 1% of the gross cross-sectional area of the column and cannot be more than 8%, you can say. Okay, so the limit is from 1 to 8%. Point number 2, which is about number of longitudinal, or you can say the main steel bars. So at least 4 longitudinal bar must be used within rectangular are circular ties. Okay, so they are just linking the number of bars with the, you can say, the type of tie. So when you are using rectangular or circular tie, the minimum limit, or you can say at least 4 number of main bars must be used. Okay, this is minimum. You can use of course more and more, which of course depends upon the design and the loading conditions or the magnitude of load. Another thing, at least 6 longitudinal bars must be used within spiral ties. Okay, when you use spring, or you can say spiral ties, then the minimum limit per longitudinal bar, that's just 6. Okay, however, if you are using hexagonal, octagonal, or any other with more than, you can say, 4 vertices, okay, then of course you can increase the number of steel bars. You can say, let's take an example of a hexagon. Okay, hexagon does have 6 vertices. So then the minimum limit, or you can say at least 6 number of bars must be used in case of hexagonal ties. Okay, now in case of octagonal ties, the minimum limit for longitudinal bar, that's 8. Okay, moving ahead, point number 3, which is about the tie size. Okay, so according to ACI, number 3 bar per longitudinal bars up to number 10. Or you can say when you are using 10 by 8 inches as the diameter of the main bars, then number 3 bar can be used for the tie. That just means that if main bars are up to number 10 or 10 by 8 inches, then it's recommended to use at least number 3 bar or 3 by 8 inches. However, if main bars are larger than number 10, then at least number 4, or you can say 4 by 8 inches bar must be used for tie. That's so simple, okay? Nothing else. Okay, point number 4, which is about the minimum tie spacing, or you can say the pitch. Okay, tie spacing or pitch, these both are the terms mostly used. Okay, so the minimum tie spacing can be the largest of 1 inch, or you can say 1 longitudinal bar's diameter. So that simple means if main bar's diameter is larger than 1 inch, then bar's diameter can be taken as the minimum tie spacing. And if main bar's diameter is less than 1 inch, then minimum tie spacing must be 1 inch. Point number 5, which is about the maximum tie spacing, or you can say the maximum pitch per ties. Okay, so the maximum pitch per ties, or the maximum tie spacing, can be the smallest of these 3 terms, you can say, are these 3 points. Okay, number 1, that is 48D, or you can say 48 times the diameter of tie bar. Another point, that is 16 longitudinal bars diameter, or 16 times D. And the third one, that is the least lateral column dimensions. So in case to get the maximum tie spacing or pitch, we can take the smallest of these 3. Okay, 48D, or 48 times the diameter of the tie bar, 16D, or 16 times the diameter of longitudinal bar, and the least lateral column dimension, you can say. Point number 6, which is about the spacing of longitudinal bars. So according to ACI, no longitudinal bar, or you can say no main bar, can be located more than 6 inches from another laterally supported bar. Okay, that means the distance between two main bars must be 6 inches. That's maximum. Okay, 6 is maximum. It can be minimum, which of course depends upon the column design. Okay, so the minimum spacing can be anything, don't know about that, but the maximum limit is 6 inches. Okay, no bar can be provided or located more than 6 inches away from another bar. That's so simple, okay? All right, point number 7. And that's for spiral bar's diameter. So according to ACI, spiral may not have diameter less than 3 by 8 inches, okay? That means we should not provide a bar less than number 3. So simple, okay? Number 3 can be used, or maybe larger than that. Okay, another point, that is point number 8, which is about spiral pitch, or you can say the distance between two turns of the spiral bar. Okay, so the clear spacing of spirals must be between 1 and 3 inches. That's so clear, nothing else. Hey, if you like these types of videos, please hit that subscribe button, press the bell icon so you never miss an update from an engineer boy.